It is a serious disease and it afflicts the patient with great speed. Like fire, it manifests itself and affects swiftly. Intake of hot, sharp, sour, pungent, and salty substance in excess, exposure to sun, and gastric hyperacidity are the causative factor of this disease. Pitta, aggravated by these causes, reaches rakta and, because of similarity in constitution, develop further, at the same time affecting rakta. Due to heat of the pitta, the fluid portion from all the fermented dhatus oozes out, which again leads to aggravation of pitta. Pitta itself is called as rakta pitta because of conjugation with and affecting the rakta dhatu, and also similarity in its smell and color. This disease affects the raktavaka srotas, that is the body channels, and the root place for the disease is spleen and liver. The disease is of two types based on the direction: udvaka rakta pitta, upward tract, and adhoka rakta pitta, downward tract. The upward tract has 7 openings: 2 ears, 2 eyes, 2 nostrils, and a oral cavity. Downward tract has 2 openings: anus and genitourinary tract. Rakta pitta caused by unctuous and hard substances give rise to bleeding in upward direction, and hot and rough substances give rise to bleeding in downward direction. Upward rakta pitta is associated with kapha and the downward one with vata, and that from both the passages is associated with both kapha and vata. Let's now see the treatment protocol for rakta pitta. If rakta pitta occurs as a result of overnourishment, that is santarpana, and if the strength of the muscle tissue of the patient are not depleted, then stambana treatment may not be administered at first. If the bleeding is stopped, it may lead to throat irritation, foetid smell from the nose, fainting, anorexia, fever, gulma, spleen enlargement, hardness of the bowel, leukoderma, dysuria, piles, erysipelas, and fistula in anum. Mostly the rakta pitta is excited by the ama dosha, that is the undigested food particles. The palliative measures for rakta pitta is as follows. Udvaka rakta pitta, bleeding from upper orifices, is associated with pitta and kapha. It occurs due to unctuous, oily, and hot qualities. To counter the kapha in the initial stage, lightening therapy via fasting is advocated. Adhoka rakta pitta, bleeding through downward orifices, is due to pitta and kapha. Here, tarpana treatment, that is the nourishing treatment, is advocated. Tarpana is achieved by giving nourishing evago, that is the nourishing gruels. The therapies that are administered to the patient having exceedingly aggravated doshas and physical strength are virechana, that is a purgation, is given to the patient suffering from urdhvaka rakta pitta, and vamana, emesis, is given to the patient suffering from adhoka rakta pitta. Thank you.